Good afternoon, this is David Wendell with Bushcraft on Fire, and we're pleased to be with you for another video. Today, Du and I want to take you through a PVC bow. We're going to take a piece of PVC like this and turn it into something like this. So we'll be back with you in just a few seconds and show you what we're going to do. Thank you so much for taking your time to watch our videos and for your continued support. Join us out on www.bushcraftonfire.net or on Facebook at facebook.com/bushcraftonfire. All right, what we're going to do here is we're going to try and get some of these coals out of the fire, get them over into our bucket. They're not all just coals. I know that there's some flaming logs here too. I don't think that'll hurt anything. We'll just put those on the bottom and they'll keep it nice and warm. I'll put these in the bucket. We don't want flames as we're doing this. We want the coals. Try and get these things on the bottom. That'll kind of preheat the bucket and get nice and warm. Get us some good coal bed. Alright, and when we got all the coals in here, what we'll do now is we'll go ahead over and we'll start to work our PVC. Now, the piece of PVC we have, and turn this around so you can see it, this is 1120 Schedule 40, okay, and it's 1 inch. So this is a piece that we chose. What I've done is I've taken a magic marker and I've divided it exactly in half. This is a 5 foot piece, so I've divided it exactly 2.5 foot, measured 3 inches on either side. And that 3 inches is going, that 6 inch there, is going to be where my handhold is. So what we've got to do is take each of these limbs and we're going to differentially flatten these. It's going to start right here wide, go down to a point. So Du and I are going to heat this. And what's going to happen, we're going to continually turn it and move it because you don't want it to get too hot. You don't want to scorch it. Some people will use a heat gun for this. We found this is just as effective. We don't have any problem with scorching. The fire is nice and hot. So we'll be back with you in just a few seconds when this PVC gets soft enough to start to bend. We're going to give this a shot and see how warm this is. I hope it's going to work. We got to move kind of quick. This doesn't get quite as hot as a blowgun, but you can see it's very flexible now. We're wearing gloves because it does get hot. And we're going to have to move kind of quick. So what we're going to do is kind of do it and then explain it to you if we don't get it. Tam's going to zoom down to where our board is there. What we're going to do is line this up right along the board. Put these two spacers right where that mark is. Put this board on here. And then we're just gonna flatten her down. Wanna stand up on her some? Yeah. Okay. And hopefully this gun differentially flatten this out. I'm going to have to get the heavyweight up there, and Dad's going to come stand on it for a minute. So you've got a few minutes to work it, but not a whole long time. You can see that those spacers are just hitting a piece of wood on top. We'll be back with you when this cools a minute. Alright, so you can see from the end here, this is almost flat, and it differentially comes up here to where the handle is. So what we're going to do, we're going to let this cool off for just a few minutes. We're going to do the other side, and then we'll be back with you once we get the second side soft enough to warp down. We're going to do the very same thing. Make sure this edge is flat. Du's going to stand right on her. And get this second side flat. Alright, so once that this is flat, we'll be back down with you. We're going to work it one more time and do the handle. Alright, well, we've got a second here. I want to show you real quick. Now, this is the part that was on the porch. So that's going to be the back of the bow, and this is going to be the belly. This part's been tapered. And while I'm here, I want to thank Backyard Bowyer, because he's the one that I learned these techniques from. And if you've not got a chance to visit his channel, he does incredible things with PVC. So the last thing we're going to do now is we're going to heat this center section, and we're going to mold that into a handhold. Now, this won't take as long, and I wasn't too worried about the lateral movement on this at this point. But now that we have this handle we're going to form, we'll line this up to one of these boards. And as we bend it, then we'll go ahead and make sure that the limbs are nice and straight. You can see that we've got a little bit of a scorch mark here. I don't think it's going to bother anything. Once that we paint it, it'll be okay. We just got a little aggressive last time we heated it. Tam was blowing the fire for us and got it real hot. So we got a little bit of a scorch mark on there. But when this bow bends in half, it should be about ready to mold the handle. So we're just going to keep watching for that. We're just going to keep turning it, and we'll be back with you in a second when it gets hot enough. All right, we've got that thing done. What we're going to do is I'm going to mold the handle. Move these coals so I don't burn my butt up. And I'm just going to hold this into place and mold it. Now we're going to worry about the lateral. Who's going to keep that right on the edge? Make sure it's right on the edge. We're going to keep that right on the edge, and we're going to keep both these limbs flat as we mold this handle. This thing is very, very hot. So I'm burning my hands, but it's all good. It's all a learning experience. And we're not so worried about how big a handhold we have. We're just concerned basically with getting it up a bit for a handhold and keeping these limbs nice and straight as we do it. And this doesn't take very long to cool off. You can see I'm squeezing it in the center more than the edge, and that's going to form that pretty nicely. I'm going to get this right on that edge. Make sure that tip's on the edge. And then we're going to let that cool off for a minute, and we should be about ready. That's getting hard again. Now what we want to do is to sight down here where we still have a little bit of time, and that's pretty good. I think we're pretty good. So we're going to let this cool off. You can see, if Tam can shoot down there, the handhold. You see where it raises right here? Get a shot this way for you. And remember, this is the back of the bow. This is the belly. So we're going to be able to hold this bow in our hand, just like that, and that hand hold's going to be nice. So what we're going to do, we're going to be back on part two with you to finish this up. All right, so you guys have a blessed day, and we'll be right back with you on the next part.